In other news, a South Korean court on Friday ordered the Japanese government to pay compensation to 12 World War II sex slaves or their families in an unprecedented ruling that prompted an immediate denunciation by Tokyo. The Seoul Central District Court ruled that Japan should pay the victims 100 million won or $91,000 each. Watch this.
나치 독일군들의 그 인권 탄압보다 더해서만 더했지 덜한 것이 덜하지 않는 것이 바로 일본군 위안부 피해 할머니들에 대한 인권 탄압이라고 생각했기 때문에
할머님들은 사실은 뭐 배상에 크게 이렇게 막 의미를 두진 않으세요. 왜냐면은 뭐 본인 살날이 얼마 남지 않았다 배상보다는 이제 사죄랑 그 일본 정부가 이 문제를 이제 계속해서 자국민들한테 알려서 이런 전쟁 범죄가 없길 바라는 마음이 더 크시지 이거를 뭐 돈
It is the first civilian legal case in South Korea against Tokyo by wartime sex slaves for Japanese troops who were euphemistically labeled comfort women. The ruling comes despite a 1965 treaty between Seoul and Tokyo, which declared claims between them and their nationals had been settled. Imperial Japan was responsible for the comfort women system, the court said in its verdict. The plaintiffs who were in their late teens or early 20s were subjected to repeated sexual exploitation, it said. It amounted to an illegal act against humanity, and the defendant has an obligation to compensate the victims for their mental suffering. Tokyo and Seoul are both major U.S. allies, democracies and market economies, but their deepening rift will present incoming U.S. President Joe Biden with an immediate foreign policy headache as he seeks to build a common front on China and nuclear-armed North Korea. Ties between the neighbors are strained by Japan's early 20th century colonial rule over Korea, which is still bitterly resented on the peninsula and have plunged to their worst in years under South Korea's center-left president Moon Jae-in.